गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस द अनदर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन द पब्लिक इंटरनेशनल ला एंड द टॉपिक पर्टेन्स टू इंटरनेशनल ट्रांजैक्शंस। एज यू वेल अवेयर दैट फॉर मेकिंग एनी इंटरनेशनल ट्रांजैक्शंस टू बी सक्सेसफुल वी रिक्वायर्ड द सर्विसेज ऑफ द डिप्लोमैट्स आर डिप्लोमैटिक community people. So that aspect has to be discussed today's class, today's, and there are diplomatic agents are those persons who interact between the two or different nations. They be called as a diplomatic agents. Basically, there are different kinds of diplomatic agents are there, but the first time in 1815 the Congress of Vienna has recognized the three kinds of diplomatic agents. Number one is ambassadors or legatees. Number two is ministers, plenipotentiary are envoys of extraordinary. Number third is charge d'affaires. So the first persons are ambassadors. In India or in the Commonwealth countries, if the countries have been sending the ambassadors to another Commonwealth country, there they be referred as the high commissioners. There is no difference is there with regard to functioning of the ambassadors or the high commissioners. Both are the same. Only the nomenclature is a difference. So ambassadors are highest ranking officials in diplomatic corps. And as they are the highest ranking officials, they are appointed by the highest ranking person of that nation, that is the presidents or the high executives. So they are directly representing, they are appointed by the presidents of the respective nations, and the president of that respective nation is giving the appointment to a person, and he will be appointed, and he will, it will be called as rigorosity of appointment. He will submit that appointment to the other country, to the that highest person, that is a head of the state, the another president. So they are enjoys the full diplomatic immunities under the international covenants are concerned. So as on today also, they be classified, they have been categorized as the highest ranking persons in the diplomatic corps. The next is minister plenipotentiary are the envoys of extraordinary. As the name itself is indicating that they are second ranking persons below to that of the ambassadors, and they discharge the functions as per the wishes and will of the state whom they are appointed and as per the directions of the ambassadors. In addition to that, we have the second rank of persons also there, the third rank of persons also there. They be called as the charge d'affaires. So charge d'affaires is a person appointed by the foreign minister of that respective country, and he would be given a specific charges to function. As per that, he will function, and he will report the matter to the foreign minister level officers or foreign ministers, as he is appointed by the another foreign minister. So these are the classification which we have arrived from the Congress of Vienna of 1815. In addition to that, as you know, the diplomat, there is another category of people also there, they become consul generals. So consul generals are the another second ranking officials under the diplomatic corps. They will be appointed in different parts of the that country where they are appointed. The main ambassador is there in capital city, whereas in some other cities, to look after the affairs of that country's interest, they be appointed in that particular country in different places. They be called as the consul generals, or they will oversee the interest of that country in the respect to commercial, contractual, other aspects. So, you know, America, they have the consul general in Hyderabad, in Chennai, and in other countries also have the consul. Germany, they have the consul general in Chennai with regard to southern India is concerned. For western India, they have in Calcutta. Eastern India, they have the Calcutta. In western India, for that Mumbai. So different countries, they appoint basing upon the workloads. They will be appointed in the different places. So they will work under the ambassadors. They will report to the ambassadors, and ambassadors will report to the country whom they have been appointed. So this is a basic and broad classification of the diplomatic corps. And sometimes in extraordinary conditions, to meet specific conditions, a separate persons also been appointed, rapporteurs, special envoys. They will be appointed only to deal with the specific matters between the countries. So they also be classified or comes under the diplomatic corps under the international transactions are concerned. Thank you.